Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 1.2, Problem 1. This is problem number 1 from Section 1.2. It says, Sally sells special cupcakes that are shaped like Portugal. Each cupcake costs her 35 cents to make, and she can sell them for a dollar. She has a fixed cost of $78. Now, based on that given information, there are 5 separate questions that we can answer. Part A, what is the revenue equation? The revenue equation is P times X, where P is the selling price and X is the number of items sold. So for this particular problem, the revenue is $1x because the selling price is $1 and that's in the given information. Now when you have that, you can figure out the revenue earned from any number of cupcakes sold, and that's what Part B asks us to do. It says, what is the revenue from selling 100 cupcakes? So take our revenue equation that we found in Part A of $1x, which is $1 times x, and we'll have revenue equals $1 times x becomes $1 times 100 as the quantity of cupcakes, which makes a revenue of $100. And that makes sense. If Sally sells the cupcakes at $1 each and she sells 100 of them, she has $100 of revenue. Part C. What is the cost equation? The cost equation is mx plus b, where m is the cost per item, or marginal cost, x is the number of items produced, and b is what you call the fixed cost, which is the cost to stay in business even if no items are sold. So for this particular problem, the cost equals M, the marginal cost or cost per item, is 35 cents, which I'll enter as 0.35. The X just stays in as X to represent the number of cupcakes that are made. And B, the fixed cost, the cost to stay in business even if no cupcakes are sold, is $78, and that's given in the problem. So the cost equation for this problem is cost equals 0.35X plus 78. Part D, what is the cost of making 100 cupcakes? So take our cost equation that we found in the previous part of 0.35x, and we put in 100 for x because the question asks for 100, and we add 78 because that's in the equation. And now 0.35 times 100 is 35, and I'll add 78 to that. I'll put on the left, cost equals 35 plus 78, which comes out to 113. So it's going to cost Sally $113 to make 100 cupcakes, and she's only going to make $100 of revenue if she sells 100 cupcakes. So at 100, Sally is losing money. She needs to sell more than 100 cupcakes in order to make some profit. Part E, how many cupcakes does Sally have to sell in order to break even? So your break even is where revenue is equal to cost. So we'll set up that equation and solve for x. So the revenue from Part A is $1x equals the cost from Part C is 0.35x plus 78. Revenue, $1x, equals cost, 0.35x plus 78. So to solve for x, I want to take the 0.35 and bring it to the left. So I'm going to subtract 0.35x from the left and from the right. Now on the left, $1x minus 35 cents x is going to give me 65 cents x on the left side of the equation. And on the right, I just have 78. The positive 0.35x and negative 0.35x have canceled. So 0.65x equals 78. So to solve for x, I would divide out the 0.65. So x equals 78 divide by 0.65. Now that's not something that you can do easily in your head. So with a calculator, I happen to have mine, I will enter the numerator first, 78 divided by, put in the denominator, don't forget the decimal, it's not 65, it's 0.65, makes a big difference. And the answer comes out to x equals 120. So in order to break even, Sally needs to sell 120 cupcakes. Now it's never your goal to just break even. You want to know how many you have to sell in order to break even. So you want to sell a lot more than 120. So if realistically Sally's going to sell 150, that's probably not worth it. She'd want to sell maybe like, say, 400 or more. But it gives you a goal to shoot for. At 120 cupcakes, the revenue would equal the cost and you would break even. And as you sell more, you make a profit. Less than 120, you would have a loss.